after the ball is over, after this game is done, after the die lot's finished, and you are short just one. Many a knitter has made a tearful and desperate call, pleading with their local yarn shop, go after that ball.
Hi. Welcome to Pen, Hook, and Needles Podcast, episode 137. It is Monday, January 12th, not the 13th. We are podcasting a day early because we're hoping that Talia's car will be out of the shop tomorrow. We can go pick it up. Because she's been driving my truck, and I want my truck back.
So. Although trucks are awesome drive. Although I figure that I have to learn how to park differently. Mm-hmm. Because I can't just zip into space anymore.
Yeah. That's a good backup mirror, though.
Yes, it does. And
the problem is the front. The front is hard to see.
It rides nice and easy. Mm-hmm. I like the way it feels when I drive it.
Mm-hmm. My truck.
But, so, my little boy, Nightwing, my Honda, he's in the shop.
Yeah, he died.
Yeah, his alternator gave out, and of course his battery did. And
on that happy note, we want to welcome all... Oh,
Who are you?
Yes, who am I? I am Marleisha, also known as Lady Fornico on Ravelry and Plurk, and Instagram. I'm not on Plurk very much anymore. I am known as Shadowlight or Marleisha on my writing sites. And Tilly, I will get back to you. I did receive your PM about my writing. I will get back to you as soon as I get a few minutes to let you know the answer to that. Who are you?
My name is Talia, also known as Franciscan Gypsy on basically everywhere on the interwebs.
Okay. We want to welcome all new and returning viewers. We're glad to have you with us. I once again wish you a very happy new year, although we're now well into the second week of the new year. We want to thank you for joining us, and we want to welcome all those who are new to the group and those who are still in the shadows. If you're still in the shadows lurking about, please come into the light and join us. We're starting this new along, and we'd love to have you be part of it. We do want to welcome those who did join us officially and made themselves known. We have Aloha Annie, who is Anne. Welcome, Anne.
Now, if you think of the Oklahoma, hello.
Yeah. Molly Munch, who is Shelley. And Shelley, you need to tell me how you came. I could have sworn your name would be Molly. But Molly Munch, who is Shelley. I love that name. But you got to let me know how you came to that. I'd really like to know. I bet it's a cute story. I think it's Elvanescence.
Elvanescence.
Who is Sharon.
Which makes me think of the group Evanescence.
Yes. Welcome, Shelley and Sharon. Now, when I first saw this, I thought it was Sister Mary Kath.
That's what I thought it was, too.
Her name is Kim, and we welcome you. And yours is another one. I'd love to know how you came upon your Ravatar, if you don't mind telling me.
Rav name, yes.
Yes, your Rav name. Welcome, Kim. Charmaine, who is Charmaine? That's such a pretty name. Mm-hmm. Welcome, Charmaine. I hope I pronounced that right. I'm pronouncing it like the state, so I hope that's correct. Abby Design.
The state?
Maine.
Oh, okay. I was like, there's no state, Charmaine.
Abby Designs. I think it's Avi Designs. A-V-I Designs. But there's no name there, but we welcome you. Yarn Sit, who is Jean. Welcome, Jean. And Crochet, F-R-B-R, which I'm assuming means Crochet Forever. Forever. We welcome you. There's no name with that one either. So we welcome
everybody
who is new and who has just joined, and everybody who has returned. And once again, if you are kind of lurking back, please do feel free to join us. The more the merrier. We're having a sweater along. We'd love to have you join it.
Mm-hmm.
12 days of Christmas.
Yes.
I did put a note in the thread because we knew we were going to have the podcast early, but we didn't know until the day before yesterday, so I put a note in the thread telling you that I would be locking the podcast, the 12
days. Wait, we locked 12 days. Are you talking about...
I have it in my notes as 12 days. I'm talking about the magazine, the
Interweave crochet?
Is it interweave crochet?
I guess so. Yes, I think so. You're asking the person who just got up like 5 minutes
brain.
Ago.
Yes, Interweave Crochet Magazine giveaway. We had, I had to close it early because I promised you all that I would pull this week. So I put a note in the thread saying that I would lock it right before this podcast, whether it was today or tomorrow. So I did lock the thread just a few minutes ago, and I put the numbers in the random number generator. We had 13 posts. I took out mine, so we had 12 entries. So I put in 2 through 13, and the number that came up was 7. And 7 is Sissy Knit Crochet.
Yay,
so yay, Sissy.
Sissy,
get us your address, please, so we can send you the magazine.
Sissy won
this issue of the Interweave Crochet Magazine. So I hope you enjoy it. Just let us know your address. And I appreciate all the addresses who have already come in. I think we have just about everybody for the other gift prize giveaways that we had. I'm sorry, I can't talk today.
And you have no excuse.
I do have an excuse. I'm tired, sort of, by association. Anyway, we have almost all the addresses we need. As soon as we get the rest of them, we can start putting things into envelopes. I do have to order some more envelopes and packing materials so we can send these out. We hope to have them out no later than the end of the month. As Talia mentioned, we have her birthday next week.
Mm-hmm.
She works the following week, and then my birthday the week after that. So we're kind of crunched for time, but we will try to get the stuff. And then we had bad weather with ice and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So we will try to get it off as soon as possible. So please be patient with us. We will get it off to you. And we thank you all for the response. It was amazing.
Mm-hmm.
For both sets of prizes. And somebody, I wish I could remember who it was, had thanked Davina for the question, and I did thank her, and her whole face lit up. So thank you for thinking about her. And before I let Taya take over, we have a 10 hours or less promo kind of thing to do. If you look at the banner of George's...
I like his new banner.
His new banner. He's got buttons. He has buttons. He has buttons, and they're different sizes. I think one is ultra suede and one is washable wool. Just check
I can't
out,
think of suede without just, thinking of the...
Oh, the cows?
Yes.
Yeah.
Jerry Seinfeld. Jerry Seinfeld skits. Can't get rain on man, I'm suede.
Just check it out. If you check on the banner, you can see his buttons. They come in different sizes and colors, and they're really pretty neat. And we're doing a sweater along, so you might find something you like.
Mm-hmm. What's in your mug, guys?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to slurp. I have chai tea. I'm so happy to be drinking chai tea again.
And I was going to get the PHN mug, but it's a little smaller than my one that I normally drink tea out of. And I'm not completely with it right now. I just woke up. So I filled my infuser too much for that mug, and I didn't want to waste this tea because it's my favorite one. It's the Dark Rose Heart. So I decided I'm going to have to just drink out of the bigger mug.
And somebody had asked us on the thread, and I did answer on the thread, but just in case it hasn't been seen yet or if somebody else is thinking about the question, she had asked if we would be selling mugs or bags or mouse pads or whatever. And we are looking into it. We just have to figure out the logistics of it. So if you are interested, just let us know, and we'll see what we can do.
Mm-hmm.
I was actually tickled that somebody wanted to buy it. That
it was...
Was it Patty?
Yes, it was Patty.
Blondie in Nevada.
Yes.
Yeah.
She blew up that board. It was
funny.
Oh, it's
so funny.
I've only read over the comments because I've been working Wednesday, Thursday, Saturday, Sunday.
It made me happy. It was really fun. She has all these really cute little
pictures,
and they're doing happy dances and things. So, long story short, if you are interested, just let us know. We'll see what we can do, see what the logistics are, the cost, and things like that. So
sweater along. I'm sorry, I'm a little stuffed up. It's going well. I'm not caught up in that thread. I haven't actually had a chance to look at it since I've been working. Our internet's been iffy.
Mm-hmm.
It seems to be going out like around 3 in the morning.
It has something to do with the weather, with the ice and the very, very cold weather. It sometimes will go out with that.
And there's nothing we can do on our end. So that's why I had issues putting up the show notes last week.
Mm-hmm.
And
I posted the video. I was so proud of myself.
Yay. So if there's issues putting up the podcast this week, it'll probably be related to that.
We're pretty consistent, knock on wood, thank God. So if you don't see a show note up or something like that, go ahead and look for the video anyway. Chances are it's up at least somewhere.
Yeah.
Unless we had problems with the internet.
Yeah. For the most part, though, it seems to be later in the night that it's acting up right now.
Mm-hmm.
But it's also making it difficult to keep up in the threads.
Did you want to give the particulars of the sweater along?
Yeah, I just want to give that warning first.
Okay.
So, sweater along, it appears like it's going strong. There were new posts in there that I hadn't looked at.
Yeah.
That
sweater that, I wish I could remember who it was. I just read it. She just put it in. It's called a spiral sweater. It looks like it's in the round, like one of those tablecloths or whatever is in the round. And I can't remember her name. I'm sorry. I just read it. And she linked to it.
I just remember that I haven't been writing down people's names.
Okay.
But,
Tilly Trout.
We haven't talked about Tilly
yet. Yes, they did. I told her I would get back to her for her writing.
Oh, okay.
She doesn't listen to me when I talk.
No. Other things that are more important.
Nothing is more important.
Things in my head.
Nothing is more important. Things in your head?
Yes.
So you have an empty head, so you have to fill it up with things?
Go and be elsewhere.
Be gone, long one.
I can't think and write at the same time. what was I going to write? Oh, Patty.
Yeah. Don't ever say I have horrible handwriting.
I'm tired.
That's her standard excuse for everything.
You write stuff then.
No, I don't wish to.
Mm-hmm.
Go on, finish that.
I told you though, I'm not sure if I did tell you. They don't like us writing, like Tara and I writing up on the board for work to write who's in what room because apparently we have the handwriting of 12-year-old boys.
Both of you?
Both of us. I told you, apparently we're the same person.
All right, well, get on with the sweater.
Sweater along. We're doing that with Knit Nerd of the... Wait.
Cappy
913 of the Knit Nerd
with
podcast.
With Kathy. Yes. The lovely Kathy. Of,
does she have another one up? I'm not sure.
Another one what?
Podcast episode.
I don't think so. I saw her last one.
A bit behind.
I've been trying to catch up, but...
And internet issues don't help with keeping up.
Yeah. I mean, well, if it's on iTunes, you're okay, but if you have it already downloaded.
You see, I watch on YouTube.
Yeah,
so.
I watch on YouTube as well, but I think Kathy...
But Kathy is only on iTunes. Or on the...
I think she's only... Thing. Yeah. I think I saw her last one, but I don't remember which one was her last one.
So I'm not sure if she has another one up or not. But, needless to say, we're doing the sweater along with her.
And her rules are slightly different.
Her rules are slightly different. You can double dip between our podcasts. Actually, if you want triple, double, whatever, dip wherever you go, we don't
and
really
if,
care.
If you're doing Denise's.
Just follow their rules.
Right. If you're doing Denise's, our sweaters won't fit in hers because they're doing a specific designer.
Yeah.
But if you're doing Denise's, hers will fit
in
ours because we don't care who the designer is. So if
all we care is that it's a sweater.
Yeah, if you're doing a Knitting Dan's sweater along, feel free to double dip in ours if you're a member of both groups.
Now, feel free to add details as I go along because I know I'm going to forget stuff because I'm having difficulty thinking right now. But for the sweater along, it is running until March 31st.
March 31st.
Started
January 1st.
Sorry, I've been... basically, as long as you work on a sweater during that time period, that's the only rule. I don't care when you... We don't care when you start it. We don't care when you finish it.
It has to be a people sweater.
All it has to be is a people sweater. No dog sweaters. No toy sweaters. No
Tilly.
Ornament sweaters.
Tilly, we have pets. She said we had... Do you read it?
No, oops. There goes yarn.
Yeah. We have pets. They're all back here. These are our pets, and it made me happy. And Tilly, you made friends for life back here because they were quite upset with us for not
mentioning
us pets. But please, no pet sweaters. We want to be an able for people sweaters.
Yes.
You know, people sweaters, babies, teens, adults, older people, you know, whatever. People sweaters.
Yes. our typical rules for whips. If okay, I know I'm gonna mess this up right now.
Do you want me to?
Yes.
Okay. One whip per project per week, and your FO whenever you finish it.
Yeah.
Okay. So people who have been with the podcast for a while know what that means, and I'm afraid if I try to elaborate too much, you'll get confused. So look on the thread.
Yeah.
But
this was the first along that we did this with.
Right. So you're allowed, if you have five projects and you work on all five, you can put all five whips in, one per project per week. If you finish a project, you can still put that project FO in there. Okay. So that's pretty self-explanatory, I think. But if you have questions, look at the thread or contact us.
We're still working on the prizes. We mm-hmm. didn't want to rush to get some choices up for you. We want to think about what prizes are going to be up there. We have a couple of...
We have three possible donations.
Yes.
We have three possible donations plus stuff in our that we have put aside that we...
Yes.
We're looking at our options.
Mm-hmm.
So we're hoping that it'll be a nice...
So you'll be seeing stuff
maybe
soon.
Maybe next week.
Soon.
Maybe next week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't wake up very easily.
She really doesn't. So yeah, those prizes need
to be determined. I think it's time for more tea.
Is that all you want to say about the sweater along? I'm really impressed what we're seeing so far. People have jumped in quite quickly, and I love seeing the...
Well, some people are first-time sweaterers.
Mm-hmm. And I'm very impressed with Shelley, with Buttons, who is who dove right into sweaters knitted.
I think it is dove.
Yeah.
Although you can say dive.
Yes, yeah. You can say dived.
Yeah.
I've seen it, yeah. But she dove right into she's a
crocheter. So where would you use dove versus dived?
I don't know.
Are you sure there's dive?
Uh-huh. So I think it's an older usage.
Okay. Because...
But in any event...
Who are we talking about?
Shelley. Shelley, who is with Buttons. So we have another Shelley now. She was my fellow crocheter in terms of... We primarily almost only did crocheting. And she is truly an example for getting knitting done. And Shelley, I looked at your suggestion for the sweater, knitted sweater, and I tried it. The yarn I tried it with split, and I decided that maybe I'll do this when I don't have a constraint
on
the sweater along.
Oh yeah, it was this one.
Yeah, it's a kind of a shrug,
yeah.
But it counts. And there's a similar one that's crocheted that I might try as well. So we'll see which one gets my attention first.
Mm-hmm.
But Shelley, I do have it queued. I do intend to maybe try it at a later date. So thank you very much. How many whips do you have? Unless you want to say anything more about the sweater along.
No, that's it about the sweater along. Hang on. There we go. I thought I was going to make noises. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
You have enough. You said you didn't have too many.
6. I didn't think I had that many.
Okay, we both have 6.
So you first.
No,
always go first.
You don't want to be a pirate?
No.
I'm
tired. I went out to breakfast with a coworker. Wow, now I can't hear in this side.
Yeah, I had that yesterday where I couldn't hear. You're clogged up?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I must be really clogged up.
Yeah, don't get me clogged up. I don't need it.
I went to breakfast with a coworker this morning after work. So I got to bed later. I enjoyed breakfast.
Yeah, she got home by the time she got to bed, it was almost 10. So,
mm-hmm.
Okay, my first project is something I was doing a long time ago, and I put it aside. I call it my pie in the sky shawl. And this is using, it's from the Key Lime Pie Shawl pattern by Sarah Peterson, and I'm using a G-hook.
You've been working on that a long time.
Yeah, it's been ages. I mean, since Turbo Knitter gave me the yarn, because I already had the yarn I won from Kathy
right.
for the last Pinktober, not this one, this past October, but the one a year ago. So this has been in deep, deep hibernation. I almost thought I was going to have to pull it out. I'm using a G-hook and Cascade Yarns Heritage Paint in the Sage Honey colorway, which Turbo Knitter gifted me. And Turbo Knitter, who is Kenneth, and Cascade Heritage Silk in the turquoise color, which is number 5626. And this is from Kathy, our co-host, when I won her Pinktober, not this past October, but the October before.
And I made a little bit of progress on it. I thought I was going to have to rip it out, but I didn't. This is where I'm at. It's moving along nicely. I'm enjoying it. Oh dear. I'm going to
Oh
lose.
dear.
Yeah. Oh dear. Not oh dearie. I am not frogging this.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
Yes, I Tilly Trout and her wonderful
Silliness.
way with words. She doesn't like frogs, so she wants
Poor
to
little froggies.
she yes, I told her they were going to be weeping froggy tears, but she wants to call frogs because she doesn't like frogs. She wants to call them O'Dearies. And I think
Blondie.
Maureen agreed with her.
Oh, okay.
So I think it was Maureen who agreed with her. But at any rate, this is how I got. I
I
was going to
like
like
frogs. I
fish.
think they're cute.
I think they're cute.
I like the ones that are kind of, the bright colored ones? Or the little ones that are kind of shiny. I don't mean like toads. I like the little
Well, toads
frogs.
aren't frogs. Toads are toads.
I
There we
used to have
go.
that book of amphibians and reptiles. Actually, I had several books of amphibians and reptiles growing up.
I think when I took it out a couple days ago, I think it was right here. And I did this all in one sitting. So it's pretty fun. I like it. I'm enjoying it immensely, and I love the yarn that I was given for it.
I want to pet a frog now.
You're so random.
I bet they feel cool. Probably kind of wet.
They're actually not really.
Really? They look like
No.
they'd be wet.
They're kind of smooth and
Yeah, they look like they feel nice.
And this is in my Knitting's My Bag, large sweater bag in the Autism Awareness Puzzle Pieces. And I love it. I'm having fun with it, and I don't know why I waited so long to get it out of hibernation, but there you go.
Me. I worked a little bit on it. I don't know actually how much I worked on it, but I must have. Oh, Mom, you got a stitch marker.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
In the ginormous Batgirl bag by Pa Blue. I use this much more than I do the night one,
Yeah, I know.
actually. Well, it stands up a little better.
Right.
And I'm not sure if the Nightwing one is still holding my cross stitch, which I haven't worked on for ages. It requires too much focus for me.
Right. That's just not what I want to do right now.
And I don't have the time to divide between designing and cross stitch and knitting
Right.
and crocheting. I just have to choose. And now that I'm starting to read again, it's just.
Yeah, that's another thing.
Well, I was in the middle of a row, but that's okay.
What?
I'm pulling a Lindsay.
Oh, okay.
I'm in the middle of the row. Let's see if this is even possible to see how this looks with me in the middle of the row. It's a
Yeah,
little hard.
it's
I think I'm on the same color I was last time.
looks really pretty.
I'm about done with this color. I think I'm going to be binding off pretty soon.
26.
You don't want me pulling in the head. I was going to say in the eye, but in the head.
Where words escape us. That's what this is going to be called.
So there we go. Yeah, I do enjoy this project. Mine doesn't grow nearly as fast as Mom's. I should probably finish this row whilst we are speaking.
What is the yarn you're using? Where's it from?
Oh, this is from the sweater.
Oh, that one? Okay, that's cool.
So it's Knit Pix Brava Bulky.
Oh, okay. All right, neat.
So, and I think this was Celestial.
It looks like celestial. It's not solstice. Mine is solstice, and it's not the
I'm
same
pretty sure
color.
this is Celestial.
Yeah, that's
But
pretty
yeah,
cool.
this, as everyone knows who's been watching this podcast, let me make sure this crochet hook doesn't run away. This project is based on an idea. There is not actually a pattern for it.
For yours.
For mine. I'm sure there's a pattern that,
Oh, there are several.
yeah,
Yeah.
actually states do so many rows or whatever. I've never read a log cabin pattern. I basically saw what everyone else was doing and copied.
That's the
So,
nice thing about the log cabin. It really isn't too hard to wing it.
no, it really isn't. So that's it with this one. I enjoy it. It's a nice cold weather project.
Yes, it is.
And it has been plenty cold here.
And it's nice, I can't focus project, which is good because I've had plenty of not being able to focus time.
Sock Bunny, she surprised me by, Sock Bunny from Sock Bunny Knit and Fit, surprised me by tagging us on Instagram. She's in Florida, and she sent us warm weather. Kimberly, I think it got delayed or detained or didn't want to go, missed the train or whatever, but it's still cold here. Maybe you want to send us more hot weather.
Well, not too hot, though.
Not too hot, just warm.
Because I like sweater weather.
Yes, I like sweater weather. Just maybe about 10 degrees would be nice, or 15 maybe.
Yeah, so we're, you know, we...
Around 35 or 40.
We stay in the double digits.
Yeah, so we're not... It was 9 degrees yesterday morning. Okay, are you finished with your...
Yes.
Okay. My What's in the Square Blanket is my next project, and it is my own pattern. Like Talia said, I saw... And
you
I
came,
decided,
you saw, you
and
conquered.
I conquered.
Okay, well, no, is that Latin again? Because that's Latin trade.
Yeah, it is. I don't know. I don't. My Latin is very.
Because that was like one of the few phrases we learned.
I know, or et labora.
And etu brute.
Etu brute.
Etu brute. You see, I didn't remember that one.
In any event, this is my log cabin blanket. Let me just.
I also want to. My R's, and you don't do that in Latin.
Yeah.
That's a Spanish thing.
This hurts my thumb, because I think when I trim my nails, I cut a little bit too deep, and I have a little cut just below, you know, where you want to push with the hook, or when you push with your stitch markers, and every time I do that, it hurts.
I offered to take care of the problem. No. I offered to manage it.
Yes, I do not wish it to be managed.
I okay. offered a perfectly logical option. I offered to amputate.
Mm.
Okay, with a lightsaber. Because
mm-hmm.
then, with a lightsaber...
I think the lightsaber is with Obi-Wan Kenner, so you can't use that.
Because then it won't bleed all over the place. It'll yeah. it'll cauterize.
Okay, this is... I think Obi-Wan Kenner has that, so you can't do that. And I don't want it any other way.
How do you know I don't have a lightsaber?
You do not, in fact. So I am working on purple right now. I'm almost ready to finish this log and move on to a different one. Why did I put...
I have no idea why
oh,
you do
where
anything.
It is. That's where it is. I forgot
you
to take it.
Got your...
My peanut butter
my
on your peanut butter.
What?
I got my crochet stuck in your
knitting
needles.
Peanut butter on my peanut butter? What?
No, don't you remember the commercial, you got chocolate in my peanut butter?
No.
Reese's peanut butter cups?
No.
Okay, so this is, it's really getting.
When I think of candy commercials, I think of Give Me a Break.
See? It's getting pretty big.
Get me out of here.
Stop it.
Yeah.
Oboe head.
Uh-huh.
Okay, and I think I finished this row. I'm not sure where I was last time. I think I might have been still on the pink.
I can't recall.
So I did all this purple here, this lavender, and now I'm on this purple here. And I may have to go another round of all these colors or some semblance thereof to get it to the size I want it to. I'm not sure.
My other log cabin's never going to get started.
And I've got the yarn for my other log cabin. I have to see. Who is this having? Oh, we have to put these into Nicole from Nicolo's World. She's doing a blanket along. And if you want to join it, all you have to do is join her group.
Is ours going to count? Because we've had it start so
she
early.
She doesn't care.
Oh, okay.
She doesn't care. You know Nikki. She's pretty
flexible
about things like that. So if you want to... If you're doing a log cabin or want to start a log cabin or any kind of blanket, go to Nicolo's World, join a group, and join the fun over there. This is, in case you're interested in the hook, it is an eye hook and various yarns.
Yeah, I use, I think, an 8. Next time I might use a 9.
Yeah.
Okay.
Your turn.
Well, as I stall,
Stall.
Let's see. Oh, I'll just show what I can't show. Which bag is that in? Bunnies!
Bunny bag!
Bunny. Bunny bag. I'm going to sneeze.
No, no. Bunny bag.
So, oh gosh, I'm so sorry, guys.
At least she's feeling a little better.
Yeah, thank you for the well wishes. So my kissing bunnies from Cloverbird. I saw this fabric, and I had to have it.
Yes, she did. I showed it to her, like, I want it!
And she didn't have the sweater size bag. Mm-hmm. I was like, can I have one in sweater size? I mean, I'll buy the other size, but I want a sweater size. So she made me sweater size one.
Yeah. She's awesome. I don't think her shop is open yet, though. I think that
is she still on break?
I think Blondie in Nevada, Patty, had said that she had gone there. I think that's one that she was saying that was closed still.
Okay.
And I sent her to Lois until because of our three bag makers that we like to go to.
Two are on hiatus.
Two are on hiatus, and we haven't done yet. I think Bakery Bears is on hiatus as well, or she doesn't have any bags.
I like her Star Wars fabric.
I do, too.
But that's going to be gone long before I'll ever be able to pick it up.
I like the Villains one. Actually, I like the Vintage one.
Yes, the Vintage one is nice.
Because that I grew up with that. Yes, I'm dating myself.
Oh, my. You know, back before time began.
Yeah, you know, they actually cranked the pictures. You know, the thing went around like this.
Wow.
Yeah.
I thought that was back when they drew it.
Mm-hmm.
And just, you know,
mm-hmm.
flipped pictures in front.
Yep.
Okay, so. Ooh, cave drawings.
Yes, cave drawings.
Okay.
Croods.
So my cute little bunnies. And in my cute little bunnies bag is my newest design. Not the one that's in testing right now.
A different new design.
A different new design. I'm having an argument with the design right now, so it's in timeout. It did get worked on. I just got mad at it. Nothing serious.
It did not look at all repentant.
No, it didn't. It has a face and everything right now. It's just having, I yelled at it. It was unimpressive, and it's in timeout.
Yes.
And actually, the thing itself is not in here because it's too big to fit.
Yes.
So it's in timeout in my room. Part of it's in here.
She'll
the
never
part
be
I'm
able
arguing
to find it
with.
When it's time to work on it. But I speak the truth.
You speak falsely.
I do not, in fact.
I know exactly where it is.
Only because you,
It's a system. Don't knock the system.
A system, and she throws it here, and she throws it there.
It's a system. So, don't mess with the system.
There is no system.
You don't understand the system, so don't knock it.
There is no system which to knock.
You just merely don't understand it, and it's your turn.
Okay, my next project is my Christmas stocking from Logan's Holiday Stocking Pattern by Kristen Omdahl. I think that's how she says her name. And I'm not going to say who I'm crocheting this for because the person watches the podcast. I made a little bit of progress on this. Actually, I think I did about six.
Yeah, we actually have more viewers than we realized who are not knitters. Isn't one of our aunt, one of my aunts, or both of them watch because they told
yeah.
grandma about
yeah.
it.
Yeah. I was really surprised.
Yeah, I was too.
They don't watch consistently, but they watch enough that I have to watch what I say now.
Well, and also, what's funny about it to me is that they don't go on any of the social media.
Yeah, they're not into that kind of stuff. So it was really funny. I don't know how they found us, but
Davina.
Anyway. Oh, Davina, yeah.
Davina is the ultimate.
Publicity person. Need to get her on George's marketing staff. So this is where I'm at now. I did make about six or seven rows progress, so it's getting long. I think I have
how it's looking. Mm-hmm. I love how it's looking.
Oh, thank you. I think I have maybe another six rows or seven rows before I have to start making the heel and into the foot.
Ah, hook.
But it's fun. I'm having, and this is all Brava worsted in cream, forest green, and I think cherry red. So, and I'm using an H hook for this. And I really like this. I didn't think I would. Hold that thought until I get to the heel, and we'll see how we like it then.
I'm sure you'll be fine.
It's working very nicely, and I'm enjoying it very much. It is in my Plover Bird, what I call the black sheep bag, and I now have a Notions bag that matches this I have to put in here. I need to get all the Notions to put in it, so my scissors and my stitch marks and all that. Yeah.
Skeezers?
So, medium bag, Plover Bird.
Blah.
Okay.
So, another one I can't show you, but we'll show you without showing you. In my knitting's my bag, Birdie's bag, is my pattern that's in testing. It's a baby bunny. And I can't show it to you because it's not released yet. It will be released
next week.
Next week on my birthday.
Yay.
So
happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Actually, a couple of one coworker, one of our secretaries shares my birthday, and then the aide who actually I was supposed, she's the one who got me the Batman stamp, so I'm going to give her this pattern for, I'm just going to walk into work one day and go, here's your pattern.
Oh, that's nice. Hopefully she doesn't watch this.
I don't think she watches. I mean, she has perfect capacity because she follows me on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
Oops. No pun intended.
Yes.
So, I plan on handing her her pattern. Her birthday is the day after mine.
Oh, okay.
And, yeah. But, I'm distracted.
Very much so.
But, yeah. It's in here. It's a baby version. And by baby version, I mean I'm using sport weight yarn and a... I'm using an E? A D? Let me check. What am I using for you, baby? This one is not staying here. This one is going in the gift box. E-hook. Because I need to start building up my gift stash.
Yeah, I'd have to do that, too.
I love making these little baby bunnies and such. But, yeah, that's that one. Your turn.
Okay, my next one is... my Ocean Drift sweater project from the Masonry Jacket pattern by Kira Delaney. Kira?
Kira
Delaney.
How is it spelled?
K-I-R-A. And I'm
that
using,
would be Kira.
I'm using a 3.75mm F hook and a 4mm G hook instead of the recommended H and G. It is a paid pattern, so I don't want to go too much more into that.
Okay.
The yarn I'm using is Plymouth Yarn Encore Color Spun Worsted. In the Ocean Drift colorway, and that's where I get the name for my sweater.
And I mean, sometimes we aren't very creative.
I like the name, though. I like it. So, if you know, it's...
That's anyway. Your excuse, and she's sticking to it.
I'm almost finished with the collar. I didn't want to finish it until I showed you, because I wanted you to see. You can see the two buttonholes.
Buttonholes?
Buttons? And what we have to do is fold it together...
Oh, so you're done with the collar, you said?
Yeah.
I wasn't listening to you.
I have to fold it. We never do. You fold it and seam it, and I was happy because my buttonholes,
they match.
Match up.
Yay.
And then you start, you crochet from there. You once this is seamed together, then you continue crocheting. And I don't know how it is, so I can't give anything away. I haven't read that far ahead. So I'm kind of happy about that. I guess it's going to be like this. And then where's the buttonhole at? There it is. So kind of like that when it's up, and it can lay down flat like this. So I'm really happy. I made a fair amount of progress on it. It's a little bit slow going because the yarn is a little fuzzy, and I have to keep an eye on the stitches. But other than that, I'm liking it so far. It's very warm. It's very, feel that tie.
Oh,
no. It's quite warm.
Yeah.
The only part of this that will be doubled, I believe, is the collar, and that's going to be very heavy. And I think it's just to allow it to have a little more stiffness when it stands up. So I'm enjoying this. It is in.
Is the collar supposed to stay doubled all the time, or can it be folded up?
Well, it stays doubled like this all the time. But and I'm not sure if there's more to the collar once I do it, you know,
uh-huh.
with the yoke and everything. And it can either stay up or go down.
Okay.
But it always stays doubled.
Oh, okay. That's what I wanted to know.
So because it's going to be seamed together. And it is in my sweater size Clover Bird. Teapot bag, my tea time bag, which I absolutely love. This bag is huge. Let's see if I can get this close. There we go.
Sometimes I regret not using the button option for this, but I didn't have enough buttons of this, and I was too in love with these buttons to not use them.
There we go. There we go, and that's in my Clover bag, which I love very, very much.
Okay, your turn. Let me just add a stitch marker here and mark my next row and do my first stitch. Because when I don't work crochet flat very often, so I'm always nervous I'll end up doing well a stitch.
Every time I see that, I forget what it is.
Well, I'll be telling you in a second. So hold on. I'm sorry, guys. I feel like I'm all stuffed up. I honestly don't think I'm sick. I just think it's this
weather and stuff like that.
And it seems to be worse when I get up.
We've had a lot of weather related stuff. And I've noticed a lot of podcasters having different presentations of how the weather is affecting them, either allergies or whatever. It's just a little bit uncomfortable and unpleasant.
Yeah, and I think because you guys always catch me right after I wake up, I'm always kind of congested-y and gross-sounding.
While Talia's doing that, I do want to plug Tilly Trout's Cozy Along for those of you who are looking for even more ways to win prizes and things. It's really cute. Some of the cozy patterns are nice. I found a cozy pattern that I wanted to do, and I was going to do it, but I don't have a teapot for it. And I may go ahead and make it. I may decide to seam up the side, you know, where the...
But it won't count because it's not cozy anymore.
Yeah, but
that.
It'd be fun to make. I don't know. We'll see. Maybe I'll just make it and give it to somebody if I decide to make it. Because I wanted to do it, but I don't have a teapot to put it on, and I don't want to buy one at this point.
Yeah.
Because I generally do cup by cup. But if you're interested in that, take a look. Tilly Trout has a neat little cozy along going on.
Okay, and I'm finished with beginning of my row. Oh, gosh. So the next one I'm going to talk about is Thor. I only did a little bit of work on this. This is Diana's Hat Pattern by Joanna Johnson. And it's Cascade Heritage Paints in the Thunder colorway. One of the few things I've actually memorized because I still haven't put it in my show notes. It's on the project page, but it's not in the show notes. Not a lot of work. I think I probably did like a row, half a row.
And we're hoping to go to the shop where we got that in the next few weeks, either for my birthday or for Talia's or for
both.
Oh,
did you pick this up in the shop?
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that. Yeah, that'd be fun. I just, because I think almost more important than the restaurant for my birthday is just getting a little bit of that in real life knitting time.
Yeah, because they're very nice and friendly.
Yes, they are. So, there it is. I'll bring the cable sweater with me, not necessarily to work on, but just so they could see the progress.
Right, because you have it with that yarn.
That I bought there.
Right.
So, yeah, it's made a little bit of progress. And while Mom talks about her next project, I'm going to step off again.
Don't go too far, because I can't show this one.
Okay, well, I just need to pull my nose off.
In my Cloverbird chai tea bag, sweater size, I'm doing a mystery toy cow. And I can't show you what... I finished the first clue. I got it today. And I cannot show you the actual project. I can't show you the yarn. This is the yarn I'm using for the body. It's called Burnt Pumpkin. And that's going to be for the body. I don't have any idea what it is, although after having finished the first part, I have my suspicions.
But they're multiple suspicions.
Yes.
So it's not...
I'm not sure if I'm going to use this for the secondary color or not. I may have Taya go through my yarn with me and see if there's something that goes a little
better.
Oh,
no, not those two colors together.
I just put it there so I had something to work with.
Mom, gray.
What?
This one.
No.
That's pretty.
Maybe that'll work.
Okay. Trust an artist. I'm not as
curious. It matches my bag. It matches my bag now.
Well, as long as it matches your bag.
Yeah, Dawn said it had to match my bag.
Well, you know, as Dawn said.
I mean, that's Knitting Wolf, and she said it has to match her bag.
It's not matching her bag. It's matching your bag.
Well, look, Dawn, it matches my bag now. And I can't show you what's in here because it is a mystery cow, and it's cute, and I think I'm going to like it. So, that's it.
I'm sorry about all the gross noises, guys.
We are getting better in terms of feeling better and stuff like that, but your turn.
Sure I write down her name.
Yeah. They never mention me anymore.
I feel like I have a sneeze coming on. Mm. Okay, so I think I mentioned briefly that I'm doing the superhero swap. It's part of the nerd, it's a nerd swap group. Hold on, let me see if I wrote it down. It's a nerdy swaps group, and I joined in because they had a superhero versus villain swap. And they're being very flexible in their definition of superhero. It's not just like comic superheroes.
Yeah, well, they said Frodo, right? I mean,
yeah. So they were very flexible. But that said, I finally figured out what I was going to make for my swap person. It took me a while. And I am making, it's an adaptation of a pattern. Apparently there's a bag that's called the, it's called the London something bag. I can't remember what it is. And I'm not going to pull up the pattern.
London Market bag or?
I can't remember. But it's, someone had adapted that pattern to make it look like a TARDIS.
That's cool.
So, and then they had made us create a strap to look more TARDIS-y as well. This is the bottom of the bag, and it's a free pattern, so I can talk about it basically as much as I want. It's half double crochet. I thought it was double crochet. Mm-hmm. So right now it's very simple. This is actually even the yarn that she used. She used a Corone 1 pound in the royalty colorway, and that's exactly what this is. Mom happened to have some in stash, so I stole it from her.
And then you will find out why I had it in stash a little bit later.
And I happen to have some Red Hot Heart Super Saver in white, which is what they also used. And I didn't have black Red Heart Super Saver, which is what they used, but I grabbed some black Hobby Lobby for the black, little bit of black I need. So, just try to work on my swappy person's stuff. And I don't think it's really a spoiler for them, even if they did happen to watch, which I don't think they do, because enough people like the TARDIS.
Right. Everybody seems to like TARDIS, even people who don't watch Doctor Who seem to like TARDIS. So.
Yeah, I do. Even though I don't watch Doctor Who a lot. After a while, the Doctor Who tends to be a little creepy if you're, certain episodes are more creepy if you're watching alone at night by yourself.
The Weeping Angels, Crying
Angels. You see, I haven't actually, I think it's Weeping Angels.
Yeah.
I haven't watched that one yet.
I haven't either, I just heard about them.
So I don't know much about that episode.
Well, the one about the mannequins was pretty creepy,
That
too.
One was pretty creepy, and they had one where, they had one where they stole people's faces. That was a little creepy. The one that was really kind of creepy was the one where the kid had a gas mask stuck to his face, and he kept changing people. I don't remember very well, but it was really creepy. You weren't sure where these people were going to come from. It was like he could make people like him, this tortured little kid. It was a bit disturbing. It's a very sci-fi show, bordering on supernatural.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, it's in, appropriately enough, it's in a TARDIS bag. My bigger on the inside, I call it my bigger on the inside bag, by Ploverbird. So, a TARDIS in a TARDIS.
Alright.
And I need to find my hook, because it falls. Oh, there it is.
It fell down.
Okay.
My next project, I didn't have on the hooks last time.
I need to step away.
It's called my Between Friends, I guess it's called, it's a stole. It's a, from the Friendship Shawl pattern by Kim Guzman. And I'm using an eye hook and Lion Brand Woolly Solids, Heathers and Twists. And I got this yarn at the shop on the bottom of the hills.
It's looking very nice.
Thank you. This is the front. You can see the pattern. I haven't decided if I'll be using the fringe or not. Probably not. I don't really care for fringe, but we'll see. You can see the bobbles and the... Well, that's showing up really nice.
It looks amazing.
So, yeah, I actually started this, I think, on Saturday. So I made a fair amount of progress. I mean, it's almost as wide as a small afghan. So it actually worked out fairly quickly.
But it's not going to be nearly as deep.
As deep. Yeah, it's...
I'm sorry, guys, for the constant stepping in and out, but I don't think you really want to see me blow my nose.
And I've got the front marked, although now with the bobbles, it's kind of easy to see where the front is without the markers. Yeah, and this I believe it's a free pattern if you are interested in finding it. Just look up Kim Guzman, and it is the friendship shawl pattern if you are interested in it. And I have it in my knitting for my bag, angel bag, the sweater size. My lowest for knitting my bag. Okay, and that's that.
So my final project that I worked on is my fisherman's cardigan. That seems to be the sweater I want to work on right now, so I'm going with it. I can't wait to have this project. It's
That'd be
fun to
so
work on,
pretty.
but I want the sweater, the finished project. This is a Sarah pattern by Jennifer Hagen. Not Festus Hagen. I am
Matthew.
And if it was going to be Festus Hagen, it'd be Festus before he got all goofy.
We're talking about Matt Dillon, Gunsmoke.
Gunsmoke. They had a character.
Gunsmoke, right?
It is Gunsmoke, yeah. They had a character called Festus Hagen. When he started out, was a trapper.
Cool.
He was kind of cool. He was not necessarily completely trustworthy. You weren't sure. He was dangerous. But by the end of the show, by the time it
20
started,
years later.
20 years
Yeah.
later, he had become just kind of a goofball character. He lost a lot of his what made him
Edge.
an awesome
Yeah.
character. But anyway, whenever I see last name Hagen, that's what I think of. So this is a fisherman's cardigan. I'm using Barocco Comfort Chunky in the barley colorway. I got this at our LYS, the red thread, not the one that's closing the other
Yeah.
LYS. It's in the other
We
direction.
have two LYSs. Well, right now we have two, but if they don't find a buyer for the one in Winchester, we'll only have one, which is sad.
But this got some work. I know you can't really tell because it grows a little slowly. Although
It's very intricate.
getting close.
It's so pretty. And it is very soft.
Yes, I wasn't sure when I initially started with this yarn if it was going to work for this pattern. I wasn't sure if it would show the cables enough. It shows the cables perfectly well. And this is the cable on the spine, and then it wraps around.
She's really dangerous with those hooks, those needles.
Sneeze coming
Bless you.
Sorry, guys.
Thankfully, germs don't migrate over the internet.
So, I'm really enjoying this pattern. And I might just have to bite the bullet and have Claritin every time I get up. I thought I could get away without it today.
Yeah, well, you just for a while anyway.
Oh, I just, apparently my allergy's a lot worse than I thought.
Well, I may have to take it tomorrow as well. We'll have to see what happens. I think it's the weather. It's supposed to be not great tomorrow.
I swear, I've never had allergies this bad. I am in denial it's anything else besides allergies. So,
What is this?
that's this project so far. Absolutely love it. I'll probably be working on it at some point
Ah,
tonight.
that's what it is. Okay.
But yeah, it's actually kind of, weirdly enough, even though it's multiple charts, it's kind of my relaxing pattern.
Okay, let me see here. I did my Sherlock, which was my one that you can't see. Do you have any writer's block? Okay, I do have writer's block, which is where Tanya got her yarn from. I frogged my Warm Wishes Afghan, and no, I did not put it on a frog on my project pages because I forgot to do a project page, and I'm not going to put up a project page just to put a frog. I think that is silly. So I did frog it. I did it on a whim for two different people, and neither one of them panned out, and I didn't want to do it, and I didn't like the way it was coming out with the yarn, so I frogged it.
And
And
neither person knew that they were ever going to get a
no.
blanket.
So
And I ended up needing the
Tanya
yarn.
needed the yarn, and I didn't want to do it anymore. It was just sitting there making me feel guilty, so I got rid of it. I embraced the frog.
And I did not have to buy more yarn.
Yeah,
Just
so.
a cute little frog. No, it has to be like a little one. You know,
Yeah.
like the ones that look like they're so
Yeah, like our Freddy.
sleek
We had a
and.
Freddy, like my Freddy. We had Freddy.
Because I picture like the really bright green ones with maybe a little bit of color along the neck.
He was a little bright green tree frog. He's so
oh,
cute.
I like tree frogs. They're so cute.
Or some kind of frog like that. Yeah.
And they're like about that big.
Yes, yeah, little.
Yeah.
So I frogged it. It is gone. Bye-bye. And I'm happy. Glad. Glad, I tell you.
I'm so happy. Da, 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 like a room without a roof. I'm so happy. Happy, happy, happy.
She's feverish.
Happy.
She's feverish.
You don't know that song?
I do know the song. Next on the hooks, I'm waiting for her to finish her in timeout project.
Yes, and bad project.
I don't know if I will. I might still do the cozy, but I'm not sure.
So,
no graphic novel. I don't have any stash in
here. I don't think I have any FOs.
I don't.
Autobiography. Did you write?
I wrote a little bit. Do you have any stash enhancements?
No.
Okay. I did a little bit of writing, about 500 words to the shared story. I haven't really felt like writing that much this week. I'm finding it very hard to focus on more than one thing, and the one thing I've been focusing on right now has been fiber-related.
And she, my one thing, she means one hobby.
One hobby. Do you have anything else?
Let's see.
Well, aside from... I finished... because you don't have any royalties or...
No.
I did finish Science of Shannara, which is the first in the Heritage. I'm waiting for her to catch up.
Yeah.
So I started...
Because I've only been able to read about a chapter a night because I've been working the past few nights.
And I know she will read several chapters when I... when she's home and I can only read a chapter or two, so...
I think I might be on...
I think you have two chapters to go.
Well, I... Paro, I woke up.
After, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm at the prisoner, which I know who it is.
Oh yeah. You're real close. You're real close.
I know who that is because I remember it from
previous. Yeah, I knew. I thought it happened later in the series.
I thought it did too.
Yeah.
But I guess it happened earlier than I thought. But if you think about it, the first book is Par and Call.
Mm-hmm. The second book is
Walker Bow, and
the third is Ren.
Well, it's Walker Bow and Morgan. They share that book.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then the third one is Ren, who I can kind of take him or leave.
Well, I like her companion, her big rover companion. And then the last one is all
of them.
So it
makes sense it would happen.
Yeah,
the prisoner thing would happen in Parker Call's book.
You're really close. I'm reading a Green Lantern comic while I...
But it's not the one I suggested for you.
Well, I didn't feel like paying $20 for a comic book when it was
but
so
it's
close
an
to
Origins
Christmas.
One.
Yes, but I wasn't going to do it until it wasn't Christmas time and had lots of money going out, so I'll buy it later. So I'm doing the one where Hal is Inspector. And
yeah, you see, I haven't read any of the ones where Hal is Spectre.
It's kind of frightening, actually.
Well,
and I've never read any of the ones where he's a Parallax.
That's a dark period for him because Parallax is basically like an embodiment of fear.
Uh-huh.
So it's something that the Yellow Lanterns release, from what I understand.
Yeah.
I'm not a huge Green Lantern fan, but it's something the Yellow Lanterns release, and he's such a strong Green Lantern, they want to take him out.
Right.
And he became Parallax, which basically like becoming a Yellow Lantern.
Well, he wanted to change him. He wanted to, from what I'm understanding, he wanted to rehabilitate him.
Yeah, I don't know enough about that particular part of...
Well, that's
Hal's.
This is an interesting comic. I wish I did have the Parallax stuff.
Well, he lost a lot of trust from a lot of superhero community when
he
became Parallax.
Yes. Well, apparently he was very dark. And in this comic, he's done some things that are very un-Jordan-like in this one. So.
Well, it's because when he's Spectre, he's not just him.
Right.
Spectre is more than the particular person
I
know. Understand.
And there's a lot going on that's, if you're a Green Lantern fan, you can check out the comic yourself. I don't want to give any spoilers away.
Yeah, and I only know what I know from actually, like, other characters' comics interacting with Hal.
Right, well, Jon Stewart's very annoyed at people not trusting him, so, not trusting Hal.
Well, I know that Nightwing and the Wally West Flash had a bit of a conversation because... You know, bats, the bat people, they don't trust anybody.
Right. Right.
And Wally grew up trusting Hal because he and his uncle were best friends.
Right.
So, sorry, nerd out.
In case you don't know, Wally's Uncle Barry was the original Flash.
Well, second Flash, because there was the World War II Flash who had the saucepan on
it. He's a Barry is the one most people realize remember.
Yes.
He's
the one in the current Flash series, mm-hmm. and he's the one in the Flash series before that, back mm-hmm.
in 1980s.
Yes.
So, yeah.
Ancient days.
Yeah, so, yeah. I'm sorry, geekdom is over. Anything else?
I mentioned superhero villains swap. We talked about Heritage Shannara. Still really into great courses. I need to catch up on Dad on the art one, the Renaissance one. I need to check out Farmagurumi sent me a message about an episode Stuff Mom Never Told You covered on Night Shift Women, which should be interesting because it's not just your typical woman podcast, mm-hmm. because biologically women are different than men, no doubt. But Night Shift is going to affect us differently than it's going to affect guys. So I'm interested in how Stuff Mom Never Told You is going to cover that.
Right.
That's put out by Stuff You Should Know podcast company, conglomerate, I'm not sure what you call it. They do Stuff You Missed in History Class, Stuff You Should Know, that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But that's all for me.
We do have, we had several comments on YouTube that I saw. I don't remember all of them offhand, so I won't mention any of them by name, because I don't want to leave anybody out, but there were four or five of them, and we thank you.
I haven't seen them yet.
Thank you very much for taking the time to comment and for your kind words about the podcast. We very much appreciate it. If you, please feel free to leave comments or ratings or whatever, either on, YouTube or Instagram or whatever, if you'd like to. When you do that to your favorite podcast, it bumps us up, so when people look for these podcasts, they see us.
Mm-hmm.
We want to thank people who have rated us and who have put such nice comments. Stop it. I will be forced to
define it.
All its.
All its?
All its.
So I can't do this?
That's not an it. That's a hug.
That's an it.
That is a hug. If you watch the Croods, you will
see.
Hug
me.
No.
That's a reference to the book we're reading.
Yeah. To be more accurate, the one I just finished reading.
Yes, and that's actually something really creepy in the book. Yeah. Not crude creepy.
No, it's creepy as in Heidi's kind of creepy.
Yes, as in like
Undead Yarn's kind of creepy.
Yeah.
That kind of stuff.
It's just, you gotta read the book.
Yeah, it's spooky.
It's spooky.
Yeah. Okay, want to thank, before we forget, I did thank the people for the YouTube,
up?
I don't know, the YouTube reviews. We want to thank the people who have contacted us with offers to donate prizes for the sweater along. We want to thank you as well. We will finalize that so we can put it on the list of prizes. And then we want to thank Bella Sox for her donation and Maria Wilhelmina for her donation that have been helping us very much in the last few alongs that we've had. We appreciate that. You guys are fantastic. You make the wonderful prizes that we give out possible, and you make the podcast and the alongs possible as well, because without you, we can't do it. So we thank you. Do you have anything else you want to say? Will you behave yourself?
Meow.
Meow. I won. She thinks she won. I let her think that because, her ego gets really bruised very easily. So, we want to thank you for joining us, and we hope you have a wonderful weekend, week. I guess it's Monday, so it's going to be a week.
Yeah.
Depending on when you see us, we hope that your days are full of all the things that make you happy, whether knitting, crocheting, whatever it is, hot tea or coffee. Sorry, I don't like coffee. Whatever it is that makes you happy. And we hope to see you next week here at Pen, Hook, and Needle. And this is Pen, Hook, and Needle's episode 137. And that's a wrap.